Okay, what we have here today is a Groms Precision Model S20, licensed by Western Electric, mono tube amplifier. New in the box, new in the original box, never been used. I've only used it to test it. I just picked this up and it's going to be for sale. And it is beautiful and it works great as well. Here's the original box. Gives you the model number on it. Looks like it was originally sent to the Echo Sound Equipment Company up in Minneapolis, Minnesota. And I just made a video previous to this and I had this thing cranked and it sounded really good, but unfortunately the camera microphone can't handle it. So I'm going to redoing this. I'm going to keep the volume down low on it. It's too bad too, because this sounds really nice. Other than the cheap cassette deck and the there's a couple flaws on the cassette tape that I'm using. I didn't feel like digging out an old cassette any better than this U2 one that I'm going to use. You know, the only thing, only small issue with this is the bass control is in reverse. The minimum is the maximum is the minimum. Could be the reason why this was never used. It's possible they got a new one in exchange and just put this in the box and it has never been used. Still new in the original box. I do have the schematics for it on a PDF file. And it has five tubes. I'll go around the back and show you those. And it has a 6V4, and that's a Bugle Boy 6V4. Two 6BQ5s RCA, and two 6EU7s. And you can see it has a booster amplifier output. And it takes 4 ohm. There's the board for the speakers. This is the ground. Then it goes 4 ohm, 8 ohm, 16 ohm, then a 25 volt, 70 volt, and there's something else written underneath the board. I have it on the schematics. I can't remember what it says. Sort of weird that that's like that as well. And you can see it's a Western Electric product, which is very cool. Very small amount of dust inside. Little spot of glue on that transformer. Very clean, very nice. And according to the blue book on the internet, this is extremely rare. It's been sitting in a box for some 40 to 50 years and has gone unused. It's new and it looks new. Beautiful condition. Sounds really well too. The only thing I've used it for is to test it. Sort of reluctant to sell it, but I'm afraid it'd just be another one of those amplifiers I have sitting around here for years and end up selling it anyway. So I'm sure somebody could use this for a guitar amp, head or something. Probably a lot of different uses for it. And it's nice. Even has that little special edition of that PE that lights up. Really nice. And here's the original box. And it does have those plugs that go on the back. I'm not sure what they're for. One of them got cracked or the plastic chipped on shipping. Those little buggers that go on the back of the unit, I'm not even sure what they're for, to be honest with you. So yeah, this will be shipped back in the original box and it will be double shipped or double packed inside of another box. Be wrapped in plastic wrap. Has a power monitor light there, also has a level adjustment. Has your treble, your bass, master gain, auxiliary and phono, and two mic controls. And it says 20 watts. 20 watts, 20 vintage watch, which in today's wattage, I don't know what that would be, but seems to push that JBL L100 quite well. Unfortunately, I can't crank it because it just distorts the audio on the camera. So let's So it's way down there. It's on right below number 2 on the master volume control. Put it right on number 2 there. I had it up to about number 7. It sounds really good. It has good bass. It really pushes these speakers quite well for being 20 watts. And again, you're only hearing the right side too. I guess mainly this is just going to show that it does work and does what it's supposed to do. And you can hear a difference in the bass here. The maximum, as you can hear, it takes all the bass out. The minimum puts it in. Treble's all correct. Really sounds nice. Another good thing about this is the tubes that it does take aren't going to cost you an arm and a leg either. Short video, plays fine, no scratchy pots by the way, nothing scratchy, it's beautiful.